It's also nice timing because it was. Wait a second, can I? Yeah. It's a tutorial stuff because I don't even know if I even shown this one off. I've explained all of this already. If anyone wants to find out about any of this, yeah, whatever. Actually, I do not know myself if I just need to do something else. Nah, it doesn't matter at all. So, but what I can still do is go. I can actually do this one myself then. Going inside here, get a little bit more money. I have quite a bit. 10k. It might be 100,000. Almost. Don't know if that's the maximum. I don't think so. In terms of other things, this should be almost getting to the end. But before I am cutting this part of the section, I am first going to do. What was that? Why did it get hung in there? Whatever. Ah. Whoops. What am I doing? I need blood. Yeah, shush. Whoops. And I think there... is there? I don't think so. So yeah, before we go onward with absolutely everything, I still need to go back to a certain somewhere where there is something for us to get, and then we have the vampire stuff completely. For this, we need to go back to the castle of Trenak. I was wanting to say something else, but hey, now I remember. What? The crest we found in Abraxas Tower. What about it? Take a look at the crest of the temple of the castle. It's the same. That means Abraxas had some business here. Or he killed a royal knight who had the crest with them. Hopefully, we're going to find out about it here. And yeah, we are going to have the final piece of the equipment we are going to need to have. It is still here. This hasn't been translated! Okay, I am going to translate it on the spot. Well, we'll try out the crest here. Let's try the crest here. This hasn't been translated! What the fuck? The wall has moved all by itself. There's a secret walkway behind it. Seriously, this hasn't been translated, what the fuck? Of course, everything here has been translated empty. This can- Why has this been translated? Damn it. Where is all the tax money? I haven't even seen any of this. Hold on a second. Back in the dark corner is something. A small book? The title is Taxes of this Year. What does it say? April 19,450. May 14,293. June 13,003. And so on. Those are large amounts of tax income. Doesn't it say where it is now? Wait, here's something interesting. Payment to Mr. X in May, 14,000. In June, 13,022. Someone received all the tax money. And I think it's Abraxas. Could it be Abraxas? He hunted vampires for money. That would explain why he had the crest of the castle. So the king instructed Abraxas to kill all the remaining vampires. It's possible. But it would also mean that the king knew about the existence of vampires. And why didn't he just send his knights? Why only Abraxas? Maybe he did know about the existence of vampires, but he didn't want to upset the population. After all, there is no Vincent Reynard anymore. The people would have only lived in fear. Or maybe Abraxas was the only one able to find and kill other vampires. Maybe he was the only one strong enough for this task. If so, then there's something that doesn't fit together. We listened to Abraxas while he was talking to his employer a while ago. And he was afraid of himself getting killed one day. By the employer. But if only he was strong enough to kill the other vampires, he wouldn't have been afraid getting killed. Especially not by the king. That's true, of course. Besides, I don't see any of those communication devices around here. That means Mr. X is not Abraxas. Thus, the king had paid someone else. There's more. I hate going to Azran every time to lay down the money. Between the flowers onto the grave. It always makes me feel so shabby. But this is where we need to go then. But I don't see any other solutions to that problem. My advisors are already asking the strangers questions why I always go alone to that grave. I always tell them that one of my beloved ones is buried there, which is a lie, of course. No one must know this secret. No one must know those monsters. Those vampires, the people would get scared and demand that I send an army to wipe out the vampires. But they don't see it would be the end of my men. They are simply not strong enough to successfully deal with vampires. Luckily though, they still believe the vampires have been completely eradicated by Vincent Vaynard. A free space at the end there, what the fuck? And that's why I have reigned relatively peacefully. And to make sure it stays that way, I have made a deal with him. His name is purposely not mentioned in this book, just in case it falls into the wrong hands. He said it will be the best for humanity if the vampires get destroyed once and for all. He himself couldn't do it anymore for obvious reasons. Anymore? It would be too dangerous for him, but he already found a henchman who can take care of this job. Okay. But of course, only with enough payment. And it is tremendous. Mr. X also wanted me to give him the castle crest that he could give his henchman. This sentence? In case he needed to give me important information. However, until this day I have never seen him. I pray to God that nobody ever finds out about the tax money, what the tax money is really used for. My knights are already complaining about the cheap weapons we are buying from the desert. But I need the money for Mr. X. It is the best for me and the rest of humanity. May God guide me. It's more like a diary entry. Incredible, so the king knew about the existence of the vampires, and he really used the money to make sure they all get wiped out. He also was afraid of his knights and thus his power. So he kept everything secret. And it seems Abraxas really was only a henchman after all. Fuck, I skipped stuff. We have to find out who received the money and therefore was Abraxas' employer. Sentence! And then we are going to kill him as a punishment for trying to get us killed. And for the death of every other vampire in the world. Yeah, yeah, them too. A really selfish Asuka. I know. The book said something about how he always put the money on the grave in Esran. That's where we need to go. Esran, that town that became a vampire. I doubt it's coincidence our journey is heading us there once more. At least there's one villa back in the corner. Emptier than empty. Totally empty. This chest is empty. Yeah, I should have gone from left to right. Empire claws obtained. And that's the final one. And we are done in terms of basic stuff. Everything else. And yeah, with that, I thought it was, yeah, basically we know where to go next. That's basically the next point section. Where is it in terms of, it's not over there. It's down below. Esran. Oh, getting loud here. Sheesh. Can I buy some stuff before I go forward? There we go. Yeah, yeah, whatever. Okay, I thought I get to a place where I can buy some 300s. But apparently no. One thing we are going to do is this. Well, this must be the grave. There's no other here after all. Do you see anything suspicious? Not really. Maybe there is nothing here and the money was simply put down and picked up by somebody. You really think so? Hey, wait, there's something under the floor, Rev. A regular shaped hole. Looks like something with a pyramid shape might fit in here. The key we found in Braxis Tower. Try it. Fits perfectly. Stairs. Something's telling me we will find the answers down there. And let's go down. Oh yeah, in terms of stuff, I might need to pause for a second. Yeah, pause for a huge second. That is all this. Esran, okay, it's over. It's somewhere to the left. What? Beholder. Behold! Nothing! Wait, what? Of course, there's something hidden in here. What was in here? Vampire stone. Nice. Okay, one thing. Can I please, GTFO? Oh, come on. Sheesh. It's getting bullshit over here. One save stone, whatever. There's also something to the left. Hello, warriors. I would like to GTFO, please. I said something, come on. Sheesh. I could have leveled up completely, but whatever. Don't need you. Okay, strange. Somehow this all seems so familiar to me. What? It can't be. You must be mistaken. Maybe. Very strange. Something in here. Empire Stone obtained. Oh god, what is this section over here? Ah, okay. Fuck off. Bleh, fuck off. Just in case. Where am I? Okay, I am somewhere down here? Wait a second, where the fuck am I? I am down here! Okay, left? Left! Okay. Okay, pause for a second. Goal is here, so... Okay. Might have something? Safe stone. Pair of blade shoes, whatever. Devil sword, don't care. Going up again. Okay. Where the fuck am I? I'm down here, okay. I just run, please. Pair of devil claws. I don't care about any- whoops. I don't care about any of this. Of course it's locked. Okay, it's not like this then. Whoops, okay. Okay. Oh, it's up then? Come on! No! I said no! Okay. Fuck off! Also, thanks for the guide, because, yeah. Can we get something? Thanks. Wait a second, is this part of this? I think this only goes up. Okay, yeah, I'm here. And for that I need to go to the left? No, there's something to the right, I just noticed. Okay, yeah, there's nothing there then. There are chests. Safe stones, whatever. Flame potion. Blah. I would like to go, please. You have to be fucking kidding me. Wait. You have to be kidding. I need to cut then. Okay, I am back again. This time I am actually saving just in case, because I don't want to do all of this bullshit yet again. Ah. God damn it. Oh, come on. Seriously, I'm getting too quick. What the fuck? Back over here, same thing we've gotten over here. Save stone and some cheap money. Not like this. At least it doesn't close itself afterwards. A potion. Nothing. Fuck off. Vampire ring, vampire saber. Why do we get two of those? That's the way downwards. What are these strangely glowing things? We are going to find out soon enough, I'm afraid. Okay. What the fuck? Hello? There's nothing to that. I need to go upwards. What the fuck? Onto the... Come on! Seriously, okay, okay, I have the entire thing here. Come on, what the fuck is wrong with you? Seriously. Now it's literally in my way. What the fuck? That is a fuck. Seriously, what the fuck? Get a sec. Thanks. Come on! Seriously! What the fuck? Fuck, I need to go to the left there. Oh, but no! It's a fuck off! Seriously! Come on! It's getting on my nerves. Oh, come on. Okay, get over here. Not like this. Still, get over here. Yeah, get over here. Yevo. Okay, part one done. Second one. Fuck! Okay, totally getting on my nerves here, jeez. It's something in terms of difficulties, but... This time I've done it. Oh, this song. Ooh, very creepy. I somehow remember this place. What do you mean? It's kind of odd. Now he wants me to bring him some bat wings. For that, I need to go to the alchemist. Pretty creepy all that. What do you remember? I have this strong feeling I have been in this place before. I can remember bringing something to somebody. Who was it? I don't know. Alright, let's keep moving. It's all very mysterious here. I already know what's incoming, but just often only hide parts of what is really true. Okay, there's still stuff in here. Why was this kind of stuff in the background? Come on, seriously. Sheesh, I could have gotten wiped out because of this. Fuck off. Ooh. Eternity potion. Ah. Fuck off! Stuff is incoming. I know it. I'm saving again! So the time has come. You've found your way here. What the hell is this? Vincent Vaynard? You can't mean THE Vincent Vaynard? Oh yes, Long Yeady. THE Vincent Vaynard. But how is this possible? Didn't you die a long time ago? Everything here is so familiar to me. Now is not the time to make jokes. It is no joke, Elaine. Who would have thought we'd meet again like this? We know each other? Unbelievable! He is alive and you know each other? That's too much. It has really been a hell of a lot of years that have passed. Try to remember, Elaine. Try to remember the earlier days. So my spell was really powerful enough to block your memories, even for several hundred years. Your spell turned her into what I met lunatic asylum 5 years ago. If she was mute and couldn't think clearly, then yes. You doomed my beloved Elaine to that existence? You son of a bitch! Spell? But why? Well... Fuck. Well... there has to be something. Well, I guess I'll have to jog your memory a bit. And even as a vampire, you can't remember? No. How do you know she's a vampire? I killed enough vampires to know you three are once as well. Who of the two of you turned her into a vampire? I did. I assume you know who I am? Of course. The memory of a vampire is unsurpassed. Especially mine. You are a vampire? But I can't smell it. Why should you? I am perfect. The highest of all vampires. I am the first vampire. The first vampire? Oh my god. That explains why you are still alive. And why nobody ever noticed that I am a vampire. My plan was perfect. None of those second red vampires can smell me. And I am going to walk the earth for all eternity. The most powerful being of all time. Tell me. Why did you place a spell on me? Try to remember. Back then, you brought me the bat wings. Sire, here are the bat wings. Thank you, Elaine. I am now going to tell you a secret. Sire? I will rule the entire world. I will rule over everything. What are you talking about? It will be the beginning of a new era. My era. The bat wings are the last ingredient for my spell. Your spell? The earth will soon shake under my leadership and power. I will control the church. And with it, all the foolish, faithful humans. Sire, you are scaring me. I am not going to reign for only one generation. No, I'm going to reign thousands of generations. Sire, stop it. Oh, beautiful Elaine. You, as my longtime assistant, shall be granted the honor to reign with me together for all eternity as my bride. But sire, you want to make me your bride for all eternity? I don't understand. As the highest ruler of the church, I'm going to allow the marriage between members of the church. You will be my bride. How do you want to reign for eternity? This, my pretty Elaine, is the result of my most powerful spell. I will transform myself. And you as well. We will become immortal. You're really scaring me. I will create a new kind of foe. The vampires. Vampires? Yes, vampires. Immortal, powerful, blood-sucking creatures of the night. And we will be the first and the most powerful of all vampires. That way, we can be a couple forever and rule for all generations. The humans will be frightened, and that fright is what I am going to use to become the highest priest of the church. I will hunt down and destroy all vampires. They will gladly give me the rank of the highest priest. And after all vampires are wiped out? Especially then, there will be no one in the world left who can be a threat to me. My will reign for all time. You want to create those vampires? and turn us both into them? Oh yes, this plan is truly perfect. You're just absolutely disgusting. I'm sorry, what did you just say? I am disgusting? Yes, you are also crazy, insane, repulsive. You dare criticize my ingenious plan and call me insane? Oh, you beautiful Elaine, how could I have been so wrong about you? You're just another little bitch. I will show you who of us is truly the insane and repulsive one. Sire! You shall never be happy again. You will be immortal. So you must forever suffer for your mistake. In Artos Uyuartos. Sire, please, stop. Have Rak in Doria. And then all I did was scream. This is the last thing I can remember. You see, my presence seems to be helping you. And since that day, Elaine was unable to talk and think straight, I suppose. Fortunately, her transformation into a vampire didn't seem to bring back her memories. So that was your plan. First you create vampires, then you killed them. Yes, at first I turned myself into a vampire with the most powerful spell I knew. After I secretly put Elaine down next to Lim's town border, I created dozens of other vampires and let them appease their bloodthirst. They did their work splendidly, and shortly afterwards I could present myself as humanity's savior by hunting down and killing one vampire after another. But apparently not all. Well, the vampires really did become too numerous for me, so I was unable to kill them all. But the vampires were afraid of my crusade, so I was sure I could enjoy my title as a high priest for the next few centuries without any disturbance. And apparently, you also slipped away from me. If only I had known Abraxas had bitten you back then. Well, too bad for you. Well, anyway, I ruled over the church and the humans for the next centuries, but I was gradually getting all doubts. Doubts about the true remaining number of vampires left. I was getting afraid they might gather together with hatred and then kill me. So I decided to search for a vampire. I found Abraxas, and he was a weakling. Weak because of fatal blood shortage. He had some wounds that didn't heal since he had barely any blood left. The moment he saw me, he was petrified by fear. The fear of his own death. Or rather the fear of his existence as a blood spirit. But I didn't kill him. No, I gave him some of my own blood. Surprised, but strengthened. He told me he was surprised and attacked. And he told me he was surprised and attacked by a troop of knights. He escaped with injuries, but he was too weakened, so he wasn't able to get new blood on his own. Without me, he surely would have become a blood spirit. I promised him if he went on a vampire hunt, he would receive lots of money, blood, and power. And after a while, he became my right hand. I taught him new spells, and he killed every vampire he could find. But why did you need him for your vampire hunt? No one must have ever found out that I was a vampire. And who knows, maybe one of the vampires that might have talked. Though, I doubt any human would have believed a vampire anyway. But I just wanted to be 100% sure. And aside from that, I still wanted to attend to my duties as a high priest. I didn't want to waste my time with another long vampire hunt. Besides, the humans might have gotten skeptical, and they might have revoked my status if it had ever come to light that I didn't kill all vampires back then. What kind of power would that be if I just killed every human? Stupid skeletons are not really my preferred type of company. Besides, for a craving body, a woman is necessary. Too bad you thought of my plan in that way back then, Elaine. You disgusting bastard. So you are still as stubborn as you were as a human? At any rate, Abraxas became indispensable to me. He disposed of the vampires quickly and without drawing attention. Sentence? I actually planned on killing him myself, but the fact that you are standing here proves you have already killed him. Only he had the key to the gravestone. Yes, we cut him to pieces. And it seems like your mistake were your hunger for power and your need to rule over the humans. And these mistakes are going to be your demise now. I'm going to do something I should have already done a long time ago. I'm going to kill you and Elaine, and your little servant as well. I'm no servant, and I'm going to kill you. You created Abraxas. So it was ultimately your fault my girlfriend died. You simply don't know how easy you made it for me. I know you are the last remaining vampires in this world. Yeah, okay. Aside from me, of course. And when I kill you, my rank as a high priest is secured for all time. Didn't the humans get suspicious that you live for so long? Suspicious? I told those fools God personally gave me such a long and healthy life. And what are you doing down here anyway? Why aren't you in a church or something?
Oops.
Alright, so you did realize. I faked my own death, since the people got too suspicious after 200 years after all. But my last prophecy was my reincarnation. Someday. I told the people my time on Earth was coming to an end, but that I shall be reborn in a few years. The humans believe me, and I faked my own death and hid myself here. In my secret room, where I was already secretly researching magic before my time as a high priest. And my rebirth shall be completed as soon as I have killed every remaining vampire. Abraxas' hunt lasted almost 200 years now, but now it will be over. He is dead, and the last three vampires are standing before me. Tomorrow I'll be reborn. How long I have been waiting for that day. You're correct. You will be reborn as a blood spirit. It will be my pleasure to cut off your heads. Now you are going to pay for everything you have done to me. This will be your last battle, so I will give you the honor to strengthen yourself one last time. After all, my final victory shall not be too easy for... Shall not be too easy for me. Otherwise, it wouldn't be anything special. Prepare yourself for your end. Okay, I'm still able to prepare. And in terms of stuff, is there anything else I could do instead? I'm just saving again. So, you're ready. Now you will die. That remains to be seen.
Respect. I didn't saw you there, so
Yeah, Donald, since when you have said that, because I also don't have anything of that. So yes, that's raising time. Anything of here? No, I don't have anything of this, so... Increasing time. Nice, 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 nice. I saw all those 69s. Okay, just in case. I don't know if he has anything in terms of status elements attacks. The only three. And I think for the demon to be most powerful, I should have been level 50, but I am not. I am only level 45. Because, yeah, if I summon one then and there, it would have only been level 25, I think? And, yeah, whatever. I could still do... Checking. Oh, there's still stuff to raise. All the defense. Okay, this should be enough. This should be enough already. Okay, now it's done. Stop with the bleeding. Thought it was a little bit lower. I don't know how many, how much health he has. Oh, of course. Going down. Has it been? Okay, I have the guy right next to me. He has 4,000. That's 1,000! Jeez! More crits, please. There we go. Yeah, just in case. I think just regular was enough. There we fucking go! No experience, because, yeah, we're at the end already. Who would have thought? It is going to be a challenging battle after all. Your powers are astounding. So my creation is much more powerful than I had ever imagined. But I am also surprised. I never thought the first vampire would be such a pushover. The battle is not over yet. Wait, what? No one is stronger than me! Do you have plot armor yourself as well, or what the fuck? Going down. Okay, yeah. Now he has 7,000 HP. Oh, fuck off. Then I am no one. What the fuck was that then? Still, set raising time yet again. Okay, this time I have all of the blood as I can, whatever. Yeah, I said this already. one more and more. There you go. More stats. Oh no, it's not. I hate this. No. Fuck off. Ah. Okay, I hate this! Elaine, heal! Eternity Potion over here. Oh, come on! No, no, no. Thanks, at least someone. Fuck off! Don't do AoEs! Oh, I'm dead. I hate this! Fuck off! And I don't think I have anything in terms of protecting it against confusion. The same thing as before. It's almost as bullshit as the fight against the king and the whole bunch. First round, no problem. Second, fuck off. Same strategy as before, stat raising time. I mean, of course, but still, I hate anyone who uses stat stuff bullshit. Wait a second. There we go. I would say two more of this. Jeez, that's a crit. Nice. I would actually say one more just in case. Just in preparation for next time. Should be okay. Fuck off. There we go. Nice. Ah! No death stuff, please. Fuck off with this. There we go. First round done. Shush, bitch. Same thing as before. Stuff has been lowered a little bit. Just a little bit. Stop with the AoEs! Fucking bitch! There we go. Do I have anything? Nah, the one that can... Wait. Only wakes up. Do I have anything else? I don't think that I have anything else that cures this. I don't even know if there's actually anything that cures it. Yeah. One thing I could do is still this. No stats. Wait a second. Nah, he has only the little one. Yeah, only this one. So I don't have anything in terms of... No, wait. Someone needs a heal, and it's Asuka. He's quite low. And I myself need one as well. I keep on doing this. No longer confused. Fucking. Wait, I think you have the one. It's like, can, nope. Just AoE, just in case. No longer confused, at least something. Fuck off! Wait a second, just in case. I mean, still overkill, but whatever. Pause, 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 pause. Total purification! Same thing as before! This time I just need to wait then. Seriously? She needs the most. He needs the most. Yeah. Seriously? What the fuck? You. Uh-oh. Yeah, for me, please. This is going to be close one yet again. You have to be... Fuck! I need to do something. Heal! I need to heal! Is it two, just two? Can you fuck off with your AoEs? I'm going to be so happy once you're gone. I have potions! No, I am doing this though. Yeah. What this? Blood. I don't want to get rage. Wait a second. Yeah, it is this. Can move again. Nice. Wait. Wait. I don't think I can do this though. Wait, I can still. Because she's going to do this first. Fuck you, bitch. But this. Come on, seriously. This time I have it. No. Oh, come on, seriously. I just can't. I'm getting sick and tired of this. No. Can you just shut it? Okay, potion. Wait, that's Asuka. Okay, this. The others need this though. Ah! Upwards! There we go. Not for him. And I can do this though. I mean, he has all the buffs already. I mean, still, I would say. More blood! Because Varna isn't affected because he still has all his stats. Yeah, still one. Okay, come on. Whatever, just trying to attack. Just in case. Just in case. God damn it. She needs it. In time. Ooh. Oh, whoa, wait. Stop a second. He can heal. And she can purify. Sheesh. You can get somewhere. More crits, please. More crits. That would be bullshit. Yes! Fucking finally, you bitch! No, this cannot be. Expect no mercy, you bastard. It's like the saying goes, the death is the end, but the vampire's death is just the beginning of endless pain. I am the creator, your creator. Too bad the vampire only can't kill his direct creator. And sadly, you're not our direct creator. That means you're going to die. Expect no pity, you bastard. You are responsible for my sorrow. And for mine as well. Is it over now? Apparently not. And all the effects! What is this? I'm not sure. Maybe Vincent's blood spirit? The energy of the first vampire? I don't know for sure. Maybe we can find a clue here or something like that. I need to save first! Because I don't want to deal with all of this bullshit again! Yeah, yeah. So what are those things? Okay! This gargoyle appears! Just in case. More stats! Amount again. They aren't even that powerful, I just checked. There we go. More stats! I mean, I don't need more stats. I already have enough stats. Ah! Don't get me with this bullshit, please! There we go, one gone. Wait, I can't do anything like this. There we go. Wait a second. Okay, I might be able to do this? Stop it with the sickness! Ah, come on. Okay, this again. Stop it with the sickness! Ah, wait a second. Wait. Purification. This should be fine now. There we go. Stupid creatures. I'm saving again. Don't want to deal with this bullshit as well. At least I can get myself upwards. What's the deal with this book? Looks like a spell book. Oh yes, it is a spell book. And what a spellbook! What kind of spells are written in it? Apparently evil ones. Ones you liked. Why are you laughing like that, Asuka? It's finally time. This is the most powerful spellbook I've ever seen. So what does it say? I will rule over the entire world. I'm going to enslave all humans. Being my food is going to be their only purpose. Have you gone completely nuts now? This red spirit is pure energy. Death energy. Don't know if this is actually completely right. Has this been somewhere? I don't know. This, yeah, I said this already. And this book tells me how I can take advantage of it. It is the most powerful soul of this planet. And this book gives me the power to become the one and only ruler of this world. I'm going to change the world to my liking. Humans imprisoned. A huge army of undead. Yes, the world is all set for the fundamental change? I was about to say charge. By me. Think about it. Why did Vincent never use this supposedly powerful spell? Oh, Varna. I can even give you three good reasons for that. First, he never had the guts to cast such a powerful spell like this. Second, he didn't want any army of undead. He wanted humans around him. I just read your comment. But the most likely reason is the third. He couldn't. He turned himself into the first vampire with a very powerful spell. But for the other spells in this book, he required a truly powerful soul. And he never had such a soul. He had to sacrifice himself for one of these spells, but obviously, that was nothing he desired. But I do have a soul like that now. I have the required power for this spell. I'm going to rule over thousands of skeletons, zombies, and vampires. I'm going to be overly powerful. I will never allow that. And neither will Elaine. Oh, Varna, you know, it's probably not bad being deprived of the most powerful being in the world. I love him. Wait, what? I can't believe what I'm hearing. You want to help him? Okay, yes. You're going to... Oh, fuck. Shit, this is not what... this is not the ending I wanted. Did I screw up somewhere? Precisely, my beloved Elaine. We are going to rule over everything. I will prevent you from ever using that spell. Oh, Varna, if you just could see yourself now, puffing yourself up like a poodle. If you really wish to stop me, then let us play a little game. I will give you one and only one chance to stop me. I will kill you. Yes. Die, you bastard. Welcome to your nightmare, Varna. Hey! Damn it, what is this here? This is everything, and at the same time, nothing. This is an illusion created by me. It represents my hatred for humanity. I'm waiting for you at the end, if you manage to get that far. This is the only chance I am giving you. Show me the vampire powers within you. You son of a bitch! Ask, I am going to kill you! Come and get me. But before that, I am going to reveal your true disposition. Wait, what? Because, as it turns out, you have become a truly kind vampire. Yeah, basically, I just got one side of four possible endings. It's a kind one. I can be a not kind one, that's the other half. Yeah, and I don't know why the fuck I didn't got Elaine on my side. I thought I had her on my side. But maybe because I don't know if I actually missed something or did something wrong actually, but I thought I was going to have the canonical ending, which is having her at my side while being good. This is basically what is being required to go into the second game, which basically starts off at that. But yeah, for YouTube, I might need to do a bonus part for getting all of the other endings, especially the canonical one. And I think a certain song will getting played that might put the video on to yellow, I would say. Would you look at that? A vampire who helps the humans and protects them. I'm going to kill you for everything you have done to me. Yeah, I basically did all of those to her favor. I think. Should have been. Damn, what's happening to me? Yeah, kind to everyone who is kind. Well, Asuka, not so much. Just as I thought, a vampire with honor is what you really have become. It will be my pleasure to fight against you. Come on. Okay, you are going to wish you had never created me. Well, now, this is the last mistake you made. At first, I thought we could become friends, but now you're on the wrong side. I don't need your fake friendship, Elaine. Too bad for you, there was a lot of potential in you. And now come for your final death. That is what you want, right? You are both going to die. Go and try, but before I forget, there is something else. I took the transformation spells from you. After all, you should wander around your nightmare by foot. That's not going to stop me. I have the map in front of me. You shall never return to my castle either. Okay, where the fuck am I? Okay. Left. Aether Mutant, I'll just GTFO. I would like to GTFO, thanks. I still have all my items here, so... Left upwards. All the way left. There we go. All the way up. Right up, right up. That's basically the end then. I mean, there are some axes where I could get some stuff, maybe, but I don't know. So I'm not even checking. Nah. Just in case. Nah. The game is over. I have found you, and now I will kill you. Well then, Velna. Try your luck. You really are only an insignificant little vampire. For humanity! Haha, bring it on, you shining hero. Okay, set rising time. And I might need to do this a lot. I would like to get it over with. Blood first. And then, yeah, just Elixir then. More. Okay, a little bit more. Okay, didn't affect. Wait a second. Wouldn't it be good first to attack Elaine? Because of potential healing magic? I don't know who of them is actually... Pause for a second, do I still have it in here? No. Should still be somewhere down there. I mean, I only have Asuka in this guide, but well, I figure, I mean, Asuka has apparently 3000, and it should be the same for all endings. Ah, come on. Just in case. Yeah. It's over, Asuka. You're done. You're so done. Wants to die, that's apparent. Why do I even get experience after this one? It's the final battle. Come on. It is over once and for all. Come on. Finish what you started. It is the best for humanity when you two die. Do it, Velna. Maybe it's for the best. Save humanity. Oh, Elaine, I have to. So, what now? Their souls. The last one. I am the last one. What am I supposed to do now? That's quite a short ending. It depends if there's still something. So this was it. The fate of the three of them. Yes, suddenly so much free time. I mean, eternity full, so Asuka and Elaine died, and Valor has now was now the last vampire in the, in the world. What an immense responsibility it was for him to be the last one of this powerful vampire race. Grandpa, that's a terrible ending. Asuka has gone insane, Elaine was also on his side, and Valor had no other choice but to kill them. Yes, Valor was thinking for a long while. He now had the power to determine the fate of the vampires. To get some advice, he went back to the Children of the Apocalypse. There it glows, the last light of the vampires. My light. You are the last one. Choose wisely. You determine our future. If you still plan on hiding somewhere and staying alone for the rest of your life, then it will be our demise because we depend on the vampires. So that's it? I'm supposed to create new vampires so that you keep and expand your power? Is this my purpose? Your power? It is your decision, but it depends, but it decides the future of the society as we currently know it. We won't be able to bribe anyone anymore. The business will collapse, and it will mean certain death for every member of the cult. Thank you. You made my decision a lot easier. After all, what are your few lives compared to the ones of humankind if I create new vampires? The future of a whole race rests on the shoulders of one single person. But this race is a threat to humanity. Is a vampire superior to a human? Are vampires even the next stage of evolution for humanity? Can the existence of such a dangerous race be allowed? But aren't the goals of humanity the same? Control. Over everything and everyone. Klenner. What are we doing here, Klenner? What a melancholic, now I can't speak somehow. Town, my home, or Aisha. Why couldn't we just live in peace? If only I could turn back time, I would protect you. But it's impossible. Now I am alone, completely alone. What's the purpose of my life now? My life as a vampire. I mean, she has been thrown into the lava, so there's nothing to that. It is over. Left alone. Rejected by the world. I never wanted to be a vampire. I am now a creature of myth. A creature stemmed from a gruesome nightmare. Born to bring suffering. Never being able to find salvation. It has to stop. No more vampires must ever be created. Vampires must not continue to exist in this world. And that's the reason why I try to do the all the other endings afterwards, in addition for YouTube later on. Because I'm going to play the second one as well as the third one. And I don't remember how the third one will going to continue on. They have no right to exist. I have to end it. Now and forever. Farewell, glorious world. Farewell, Klenna. Farewell, Aisha. Farewell, rising sun. I don't think so. May destiny be more kind to me this time. May there never be any more vampires. How sad. He killed himself. He decided in favor of humanity. The vampires should be their death. A sentence? His frustration ultimately made him do his final action. The suicide. Grandpa, I can barely hold back my tears. Such a sad ending. But it is just a story. I almost wanted to say it's just a theory. No game theory. Still, thanks for watching. Whatever. But his death wasn't really the end, because he didn't simply die. Instead, he lived on as a blood spirit with eternal pain. If you are quiet enough, you can hear his screams of pain in the wind to this day. Basically. The children of the apocalypse were forgotten. Their power was broken. The tomb in Esran was riddled completely and a powerful spellbook destroyed. It was burned by the highest member of the church, so that it never comes to such a catastrophe ever again. But the lives of the people went on. There were never again vampires, and so the people could fall asleep at night peacefully. And you should do so as well. It has gotten late. Grandpa, that was a very beautiful story. Even though the ending was way too sad in my opinion. Maybe I will tell you the story again tomorrow. With another ending. So basically. But I wonder, how could Valna even kill Asgard? Even though he was Valna's creator. It was because of the place where they had their battle, in this ether plane. This rule doesn't apply. I see, so in a normal world, Valna couldn't have killed Asgard. Exactly, Asgard knew that and was fair for the first and last time in his long life, so he created the ether plane. Whatever. But now you should sleep, otherwise your father is going to get mad at me for keeping you awake for so long. Well, how long has it been? How many hours? Whatever. I mean, including all of the grinding I did in between all the streams, all the parts, sessions, whatever. And that you are going to be tired tomorrow the whole day long. Good night, Grandpa. Good night, Simon. That's it? I thought it just goes to black and goes on to the main screen. I think that's it. I'll just check everything here then. It is this, that is this. Wait a second. I think I bugged it out? Nah, I don't know. The last one. I am the last one. But I won't stay alone for long. I will change the world. Asuka was right. It is time for the world it is time that the world changes. But it won't be Asuka ruling, it will be me. Asuka was a weakling. He could have never ruled the world. And Elaine chose the wrong vampire, and that was a punishment. Tomorrow, the world will plunge into chaos. Now it is me alone who has the power to lead the vampire race. I am going to control thousands of skeletons, zombies, and vampires. Finally, I am reaping the benefits of my transformation. So this was it. The fate of the three of them. Asuka and Elaine died, and Velna was now the last vampire in the world. What an immense responsibility it was for him to be the last one of this powerful vampire race. Vampire, that's a terrible ending. Asuka has gone insane, Elaine was also on his side, and Velna had no other choice but to kill them. But Velna became an evil vampire. He was just like Asuka, power hungry, and in the end he became deluded as well. With the souls of Asuka and Elaine and the spellbook of Vincent, he had almost unlimited power. He knew that and he took advantage of that. First, he flew back to Asuka's castle and fitted it out to his liking. Then he began making evil plans how to get the world under his control in the fastest way. He created hundreds of skeletons and zombies which he used to attack the towns of this world. He wanted to imprison the people so he could use them as food. And I think the very next thing, because of the song, and it's loud. Maybe too loud to get stricken. It is time. Now we are going to conquer the world. First, we are going to burn down Klenna, that wretched town. I never want to be reminded of it ever again. Then we are going to wipe out the church systematically. In return for making Vincent Vane a high priest back then. Then we move to the other towns and eventually to Azerrand. We are going to burn it down completely. And we shouldn't forget those children of the apocalypse either. We're going to destroy their hideout and put the remaining cult members into prison to the other prisoners. If the humans don't kill them, I will. After all towns were looted, I'm going to create more vampires. The world will tremble under my rulership. The sky will turn blood red. I'm going to rule without mercy, because I am more powerful than God. Asuka 2.0 or what? Well, and so began the bloody act of destruction by Velna. Klenna. Kill them all, destroy all houses. Let blood flow. Blood. No mercy for these loathsome humans. You hideous humans, I'm going to crush you like small insects. Destroy everything! Kill everyone! I am more powerful than God. No one must question my might, and I will never work with these cold people. So kill them! Take down the walls, nothing shall keep standing. Of course, looping. And in a remarkable short amount of time, Velna managed to subject the world. sentence? What is it? Master, we plundered all the towns like you ordered. The humans are stored in specially human camps where you can do with them whatever you wish. Any problems? No, master. All towns are destroyed. Your vampires are roaming the lands. Blood is flowing on the streets. No bird is left crowing. What? Chirping me. The world is in chaos. And I have reached my goal. I followed my destiny. I'm the most powerful being that has ever existed. That begs the question what I am going to destroy next. Power is the goal. But too much power means death. The sky turned red again. And the human race died. For all eternity. Was there something else? I think it was the second game. And so it came that really the entire human race slowly died out. Jammed together in special camps like that, humanity could not survive for long. But without the humans, the vampires died out as well. And so Valna too died because of blood shortage and became a blood spirit. This madness ultimately meant the end of the world, like an apocalypse. His obnoxious behavior killed him in the end. Too much power is baneful. That's right, not a single being in the world can control the entire world. And the eradication of other races eventually leads to one's own death. War has no winners. But didn't the humans try to fight back? Of course, but Valna's army was too large and came too unexpected. He had too much power and humanity didn't have a leader like Vincent Vaynard. Vincent Vaynard was back then. That was a really fascinating story, Grandpa. Even though the ending was a little too bloody. Maybe I will tell you the story again tomorrow with another ending. Now we are the two last vampires of this planet. Not on this planet. It was fate, that's how it must be. What do we do now? I don't know, Valna. But I'm glad we are still together. So am I. That's that way we can change the world together. What do you mean? Change the world, the two of us. Eskar was right. The world must change, through us. We will create new vampires. New vampires. Yes, that's a very good idea. Let us create new vampires. Let us revive the race of the vampires. It shall rule the earth. Not those loathsome, weak humans. Yes, and this book will help us. And from now on begins a new era. The era of the vampires. Does this mean? So this was it, the fate of the three of them. Eskar died, and Elaine and Valna were now the last vampires in the world. What an immense responsibility it was for them to be the last ones of this powerful vampire race. And Valna and Elaine were now together and wanted to revive the vampire race. Precisely, both of them had an evil attitude towards humanity. It looked like they wanted to stay together for the next centuries and decided the future of the Earth. And so they began creating the first new vampires. Oh man, what a stupid idea to go through the forest in the middle of the night to get to Uria. But the girls there are going to comfort me. I'm looking so forward to the Spanish room. Just why do I have this strange feeling? Got you! Ah! That was number 7. Ouch. Damn it, something bit me. And so they created one vampire after another. And of course, the new vampires created new ones as well. What the fuck is going on to the right? Oh, yes, oh. Damn, you're good, yes, what the fuck? Oh, fast, what the fuck, yes. Yeah. Hey, why did you stop? I still have other customers today. Or have you come already? Melina always gets the best man. Judging by her scream, she must have one hell of an orgasm. Well, sort of? And so even more vampires got created gradually. The world changed in an instant. The humans were haunted, the vampires reigned. What happens if the balance of the nature gets destroyed? Will it destroy nature? An organism alien to this peaceful world. Is this the end of the world? Or is there a cure? Can a war be this cure? Whoops, I whatever. Oh, will it be the end once and for all? Well, I think we know where this is going. My fellow citizens, humanity is at war. The vampires kill one human after another. We have to put an end to it before they spread over the entire world. But then it will be too late. I was given the rank of the High Priest so I can lead the battle against the vampires. I have proven my skills as a warrior many times before. And I'm going to prove my skills as a leader now. I hereby declare the holy war for humanity against the vampires. We must not lose this war. History has proven that we can win such a war. But unlike the disappointing Vincent Vaynard, we are going to eradicate all vampires. And so, it came to another holy war. But this was a war humanity could not win. Their new leader, Feyran Riddes, didn't have the abilities of a Vincent Vaynard. It was a last resistance against the. It was the last resistance against the vampires, and they did get killed by the hundreds. And it was not enough. Humanity died out, but vampires soon had to realize that humanity's demise meant their own death as well. So both sides of the war died. Yes, without the blood of the humans, the vampires could not survive for long. And enraged, caused by the blood shortage, Velna and Elaine fought against each other in the end. They say you can still hear their fight in the wind to this day. It was a really fascinating story, Grandpa. And a nasty ending. But I rather would have liked some other ending. Maybe I will tell you the ending again, the story again tomorrow with another ending. Now we two are the last vampires on this planet. If that was fate, that's how it must be. What do we do now? I don't know, Velna, but I'm glad we are still together. So am I, Elaine. Let's return to Castle. Okay, we will think about what to do there. So this was it, the fate of the three of them. Eska died, and Elaine and Velna were now the last vampires in the world. What an immense responsibility it was for them to be the last ones of this powerful vampire race. Grandpa, that was really a fascinating turn of events. And now Velna and Elaine were a couple, an undead couple. That's right, during the events of the story, Elaine fell in love with Velna. And Velna felt the same for Elaine. Both of them had enough of the monster myth of the vampires. They realized it would be best for the world if they remained the last two vampires. Aside from one little exception. Grandpa, you can't mean... Yes, yes, that's exactly what I mean. Alright, my little girl, now you're looking splendid once again. But Dad, all the guys will wolf whistle me again. That's totally annoying. Oh dear, you should be happy you are converted by the humans. Now we have been living here for so long, and I almost feel like a human. If it weren't for these fangs... No one can see them. Your vampiric aura let the humans think you look normal. And that's good that way. We want to live among them, after all. That's why you must never turn a human into a vampire. It's too dangerous for us. We've been living here for 12 years now. We don't want to risk our current situation, our friends, our home. I get it, Mom. I will be careful not to transform a human. Good girl, my daughter. Aren't you also hungry? Now that you mention it, let's go and find a lonely human somewhere. Okay then, off we go. Get loud. It is honorless to hide one's true nature. Is it honorless to hide one's true nature? Man? Is it necessary to hide throughout the whole life? Depends. Can the vampire live among humans? Well, they will judge. Does a vampire have to be evil? Well, look at Twilight. There. Aren't the deeds what makes someone good or evil? Or is it the species alone? Nah, it's the actions. You know, Elaine, sometimes I wonder what we, what would we, nah. Sometimes I wonder what would have happened if Asuka hadn't gone insane like that. Strange. I'm almost thinking about that sometimes. Then everything would probably be different. We wouldn't have a daughter. And we probably would live in a castle. I wonder what they did with Asuka's coffin now that the castle is inhabited by humans once again. I assume it was burned, like many other things as well. And what happened to Ronak anyway? I think he is now part of some sort of circus of curiosities. You think he deserves this? I suppose not, but at least he wasn't killed. And I guess he is not worse off than he was under Asuka's sway. I hope so for him. I kind of feel sorry for him, though. Me too. How about we free him? And then what? He can't live here. Why not? I simply make him look like a human or a pet. I have the power for that, thanks to the book. That's a good idea. I take a look and see if there is such a spell written in it. Strange. Didn't you put the book on this shelf? I did. Don't tell me it's gone. Oh no. I think we're warped. Phew, what a climb. Soon I will be rewarded. Unlimited power. That will be awesome. My lord, I got what you wanted, the book. Ah, at last, well done. Thank you, my lord. I have eavesdropped on them a little after their daughter left the house, and they seem to think your castle was cleared out completely, and that your coffin was destroyed. Those stinking fools, soon they will pay. And they also know Ronak is in some kind of curiosity circus. I suppose I will free him on occasion. My lord, it has been many years. Years full of pain. Too many years. But I just couldn't resist the pain and get control of my senses back earlier. But now, the time has come. I came to you, gave you an order, and now you brought me what I wanted. The book. Yes, my lord. And then you shall receive your reward for that. Thank you, my lord. You are too kind. And now, cast a spell, the spell through which I will become flesh again. Yes, my lord. Okay, here we go. This is the only spell book in the world that contains a spell to turn back a blood spirit into a vampire. That one. In Noxteria, vivification of a blood spirit. Vivification? Ah, okay. Vivification. Ah, okay. It's a command, my lord. And then you will really give me some part of your power? Yes, yes, of course. Cast a spell already. In Devox. Annus Darus. Go on. El Solda. Umbro Par. You foolish little human. Finally I'm back. What you said? Well, you shouldn't have trusted Asuka. Last count of three. I said nothing. My lord, what are you doing? Such a fool. And now I'm going to take a look at the book. And then those two traitors are in for it. Didn't the little worm say something about a daughter? Yeah, that gives me vicious idea. A vicious idea, come on. Bah, this is boring. Humans are dull. Why can't I have real friends? Vampire friends? Huh? What's going on now? Hello, my little lady. Who are you? You may call me Eska. Eska? Weird, the name sounds familiar somehow. Are you one of Dad's old friends? Dad never talked about his past. Old friend? Oh yes, we were very good friends. I've known your partner forever. Hey, then you surely can tell me something about my parents' past. Of course, I can tell you. I can tell you a lot more. What do you mean? I've been watching you. You seem to be very lonely. I'm afraid you're right. I do have human friends, but I'm not very happy with them. After all, they are only humans. I'd like to have real friends. Vampire friends. Lots of them. To totally have real fun. Believe me, I can understand you all too well. I'm also feeling a little lonely at the moment, but that can be changed. Come with me, I will show you the true joy of the vampire existence. You will have lots of vampire friends, and you will only enjoy your existence as a vampire. Sentence? I can't. Dad forbade me for going along with strangers. Come on, it should have been translated a little bit better. I can't force you, but think about it. Without me, you will never have real friends. I am the only one who knows where the other vampires are, and who would tell you that? Why would you do that? You don't even know me. Well, let's just say I pity you. I have experienced the feeling of loneliness myself not a long time ago. And all the pain, indeed I do. You pity me? I'm sorry, but I find that hard to believe. Well then, I will leave you now. I will leave now. And you are never going to have real friends. Fine, show me where they are. With pleasure. You're going to be with them soon. You're better not lying, otherwise I will tell Dad everything. I am better not going to risk that. Don't make fun of me. Hold on to me, my magic is going to take us to them. I can transform on my own just fine. Oh, excuse me, your father wasn't able to do that back then. What was that? What did you say about that? Never mind, let's go. What? And so, once again, Eska was alive. Together with Jaina, I think, he returned to the castle and rested there for a few days. During that time, he studied the spell book thoroughly. He couldn't use many of the spells, however, since he didn't have a powerful soul, but he wanted to get such a soul from Velna. And what was Jaina doing in the meantime? She watched Eska, observed him, and was surprised by the incredible power that came from him. Eska explained many spells to her and told her a lot about the vampires. When Reyna asked about the other vampires, Eska told her about the Holy War. But he didn't tell her the truth. He told her there were other vampires, which would only talk to other vampires who attained a certain amount of strength. During a few days, Eska studied the spell book. Didn't we have this already? Or was Jaina the one that studied it first? Whatever. Valda and Elaine were searching for Jaina. They were expecting the worst, but they never would have thought that the thief revived Eska. And while they were searching, Asuka was drawing Gaina deeper and deeper into his pool of cruelty. He told her Malicus? I can't pronounce shit. Taught her some spells, and she enjoyed it so much that she even forgot she already spent several days inside Asuka's castle. Both of them studied the book day and night, and Yaina got more powerful with every new spell. And sadly, she picked up Asuka's cruelty. And so the anger of Yaina towards Velna and Elaine grew because of the fact that they never told her the truth about the vampires. At least that's how Asuka called it. Of course, he was telling her nothing but lies, but the naive Yaina lost the sense of for the truth. As well as certain people nowadays. I don't know, it's just the 1st of November currently. But now you should sleep. That was a really fascinating story, Grandpa. But you can't just let me end like this. I want to hear it to the very end. Maybe I will tell you the story again tomorrow with another ending. Nope. I will be showing the story how it's going to be continuing. This is the very plot point. On how it goes on to Vampire's Dawn 2. And we will be taking a look of that next week, which will be 7th of November, yeah. I wonder, how could Velna even kill... it's basically the same again, I would say, but yeah, whatever. But I wonder, how could Velna even kill Asuka, even though he was Velna's creator? It was because of the place where they had their battle, and this ether plane... In this ether plane, this rule doesn't apply. I see, so the normal world... I see, so in the normal world, Velna couldn't have killed Asuka. Exactly. Asuka knew that and was fair for the first and last time in his long life. So he created the ether plane. But now you should sleep, otherwise your father is going to get mad at me for keeping you awake for so long and that you are going to be tired tomorrow for the whole day. The whole day long. Good night, Grandpa. Good night, Simon. Simon Rage, you are truly a seemingly boy. Vampire's Dawn. A game by Alexander Koch. English translation by KJ150. Well, you missed a few spots, boy. Special thanks goes to the following persons. The people should have said, come on. Okay, who is the special thanks? Well, several then. To you as well. So many exclamation marks. Special praise goes to the staff of course, RPGMaker.de. Yeah, it was a German game, so... Additional word of thanks goes to the following people. because I took the liberty of taking a few things from their game and edited them. You did? Not reading that a lot. And the following nice people helped me with several little things. Well, okay. Of course. Several beta testers, of course. Wait a second, there were beta testers? To what? The translation or to the game? This.com. I hope you had fun playing Vampire's Dawn. Well, I had. Sort of. I had to look into a guide, but still. You're Malex. The end. I should put this at the end, I think. Wait, what? This is basically New Game Plus, I would say. Attention, the game is now going to start from the beginning. However, the character levels and nearly all spells and items will be kept. So this is going to be a New Game Plus. I said that already. Though you receive an additional item called Save Crystal. With this, you can save as many times as you want. Maybe you wish to complete the game once again, and this time you might want to change your disposition. Try to play as a good vampire. There are, by the way, 4 different endings on which one hand depend on your humanity level, and on the other hand on your behavior towards Elaine, as well as your number of escapes. That might be the reason. Because I escaped so many times, that might be the reason why I got the good ending, but all alone. the good ending, but forever alone. There we go. Have fun. Whatever. Was this the same one? It's something else, I'll say, but still.